What now? You sweating yet, Dutch?
Of course I'm sweating. We're in some disease-ridden, swampy, Dixie-whistling shithole.
I meant about what Trelawney said about these bounty hunters.
Well, not sweating as such, but maybe a little gentle perspiration. Until we know more, ain't too much harm in wasting good liquor on sweating.
So?
So, I think you should pay Mr. Trelawney a visit and find out exactly what he knows and who he spoke to. Take Charles with you. Oh, the sight of the pair of you would make a statue sing out its secrets.
Okay. Evening.
Evening, Arthur.
Hey, Lenny.
Charles, I need you for some business in town. Come on.
Okay.
Have a nice evening.
Survived another day.
Where are we going?
Dutch wants us to have a talk with Trelawney about these bounty hunters who are coming for us. Hoping he can tell us who they are or where they're coming from.
Okay. And you're deputies now.
Something like that. Soon as we laid eyes on that fool of a sheriff who runs that town, I knew Dutch was gonna play him like a fiddle.
On the run from one bunch of lawmen, working for another. Interesting.
Hiding in plain sight, Dutch calls it.
So, spirits seem good. In the new camp, I mean.
We got some space between us and that mess now. Ain't seen no more Pinkertons for a while. There's these bounty hunters, of course, but Dutch don't seem too worried about it.
Can't believe they're still coming after us. We didn't even get away with the money.
Yeah, but they don't know that.
Of course. Trelawney. I've only met him a couple times, but he's a strange one.
Fear not. He's just a cockroach in fancy britches. But he gets into nooks and crannies the rest of us can't. We just need to find him before he scurries off again. Hey, you're okay, girl. I think it's just up here.
Someone got here first.
So it seems.
By the looks of things, it wasn't a social call.
Check the house.
Gone.
Shit. This don't look so good. Well, he clearly ain't here, so where is he?
Let's take a look around.
This food's barely touched. Looks like he left in a hurry.
Found anything?
Bed's not made, so he must have been here recently.
Big struggle. Pretty recently, I'd say. I guess maybe 12 hours ago.
But no body?
Not yet. Look, tracks. Come on.
There's some blood here. That ain't good.
Come on, before they get too far ahead.
Okay, girl.
They went down the path here. How's your tracking these days?
All right, I guess.
Well, lead the way then.
Not the kind of place I'd expect to see Trelawney staying in.
No?
Normally scams himself into the best hotel in town.
You know, when me and Javier went down with Trelawney to get Sean after the bar fight, I swear, he talked the whole way and never actually said a damn thing.
I thought you knew. That's his special talent. They could be 20 miles away by now.
We can track them that far if we need to. Depends on how much you want to find them.
Yeah. I still ain't sure about that.
Hey, look. They continue on the other side of the tracks.
Huh.
They seem to head into the forest now.
Hey, look. Let's go see what those fellas have to say.
What's wrong, Arthur?
Yeah!
Excuse me.
Yeah?
Have you seen him? We're looking for our friend.
I don't think he's here.
You seen a strange sort of feller? Sort of formal?
Strange? Sure. Formal? Nah.
He uses a cane. Looks a lot like this one.
Yeah. All right, you two. Where the hell is he?
You both better get out of here!
Come here!
You are! It's Trelawney.
I don't know anything.
Tell me where he is.
You go to hell.
You better tell me now, you son of a bitch.
Okay. Okay, for Christ's sake. They took him to a cabin over by the cornfields.
Which cornfields?
Left. Down the path there by Braithwaite Manor.
Let me see you again, you hear me?
You got lucky there, my friend.
Come on, let's go.
Yeah, good girl. Follow me. I think there's a way around so we don't have to go through the Braithwaite's place.
Yes. I've spent enough time there. After you, then.
You okay?
I'm good.
What do you think they want with Trelawney?
Could be any one of 100 things. Just depends if any of them involve us.
You think he'll talk?
Of course he'll talk. He'd sell his own sister to save a train fare. He don't know how not to talk. He don't know where we're holed up, though. At least I don't think he does.
I don't know why Dutch still deals with him. Always disappearing for weeks on end.
He's got his uses, and, well, loyalty matters to Dutch.
Of course. But is Trelawney loyal?
Kind of. I guess Trelawney ain't exactly disloyal. Just got a big mouth. Don't worry. If he talked, I'll goddamn find out what he said. Nothing's ever straightforward where Trelawney's involved. Learn that much.
I mean, how much time have we wasted getting this fool out of trouble?
He somehow manages to be both lucky and unlucky at the same time.
That's one way of looking at it.
But he always finds some way to pay us back. Just when we think about cutting him loose, he brings us something big. I guess that's his special talent, keeping fish on the line. That must be it.
Oh.
Let's get you out of here. Come on, boy.
The thing is, after that shack, this will be remembered like a good time.
Put the man down, gentlemen. Is that the lot of them?
I think so.
So you're alive.
Allegedly.
Well, don't worry, they won't be for much longer.
Okay, go get them, Arthur. I can handle this.
Over there, where the birds are.
something on the ground over here. He's dumped his gear. Look around. He can't have gone far.
He's mine! Let me take him and get out of here.
You have my friend.
He's not your friend. I'll give you money.
Be quiet. Come on.
He should have taken the money.
I know. I'm a fool.
Shit. Thank you. Gunshots are coming from that barn. Come on.
Should be the last of them. All right, let's go back for Trelawney. You all right?
Yeah. Never goes easy, does it?
Sure don't. Come on. Let's go see how badly they beat up the slippery fella.
I wonder how much trouble he's brought with him.
Guess we'll soon find out.
Seems like we can't catch a break now, Arthur.
Our luck's held this long. We... not out of worse scrapes than this one.
So I heard.
Sure. What's government agents and bounty hunters to us?
I hope you're right. Come on. Let's not drag this out any longer.
Well, he's still here, at least. Put your feet up, why don't you?
You okay?
Never finer.
So, who was they?
They were bounty hunters. Attached to Cole Stoudemire.
Okay.
They weren't looking for me, per se.
What'd you tell them?
Not much. I told them I was an intellectual. Come down here from Oregon, looking for a job at the university. Of course, they didn't believe me. Seems you stirred up quite a hornet's nest in Blackwater.
So I keep hearing.
It might be best if I stay with you, gentlemen, for a while. Can't go back to that caravan now.
All right, Charles. You take Trelawney back to camp. I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
There always seems to be more. More and more civilization. I want to get back in the open country of the West, or what's left of it, but well, even that ain't the way I remember it. Okay, girl. Morning to you.
Fine day to you.
All right. Howdy. Work, you slobs.
Fine morning.
I don't see much. Do you care to sing my song? I don't know.
What you want?
You okay?
Do I look okay?
No. You look awful.
Awful. Look at me. Useless. I wasn't born to this. I didn't deserve this. I used to be a gentleman. Jeremiah Compson. Compson's stead.
Good for you, if that's anything to boast about.
They took everything from me.
Who did?
They.
And what did they take?
My whole life. A whole way of living, a career.
I stole a lot of things, but that's quite a lot to steal.
Look at me here. Living in the shit and in the mud.
I'm sorry.
My old house. The house my grandfather built. It's all dilapidated and destroyed. Repossessed by the bank.
I'm sorry to hear that.
I was supposed to live a different life.
Me too.
If only I could get my old things back. Personal mementos, a watch, old pistol, my ledger.
Where's this house again?
Compson's stead. It's north of Scarlet Meadows. Banks says I can't go near it. I'm living rough over by Harris Field.
Well, if I'm ever out that way, I'll see what I can do.
Time. Time is hell.
Thank you. Excuse me, partner. That's a nice horse.
Thanks.
Mister?
Morning.
Hey, move it!
Morning.
Sir, good morning.
You okay there, mister?
You need me to move?
Move?
Am I sitting in the wrong place?
Excuse me?
I didn't mean any offense, sir. Please.
I don't get your meaning.
I'm very sorry, sir. You have yourself a fine day, and I apologize for any offense I may have inadvertently caused.
What are you drinking, mister?
Nothing, sir. Nothing at all.
Why are you acting so strange?
I don't mean to. I'm sorry for any offense.
How could you have offended me?
I have no idea, but I had no idea how I offended the last fellas, and they stole my wagon on account of my impudence.
Stole your wagon for back check?
They didn't like my medical practice, I suppose. I was helping folk.
And that wasn't popular?
I was undercutting the competition, or I was too colored, or I was irritating in nature, or I was some know-it-all, big city slicker here to demean some good old boys of my fine words. The exact variety of my sins was the source of some conjecture, so they undercut me.
That ain't very nice.
That was my impression. Still, compared to the gutting, castration, defenestration, and crucifixion they offered me, I felt I got off lightly.
Imaginative bunch.
Yes.
But
no great love of my medical practice. Too free with my wisdom and services.
Which way they go?
Down the road, that away.
Stay here.
I'm sort of forced to. Please don't go to any trouble on my account.
Mm-hmm.
Are you looking for that fellow's wagon? I heard him say they was taking it to Macomb's Inn.
Okay, thanks.
God give me strength.
Come on, girl. Hey there, partner.
Hello.
Good girl. Yeah. That's my girl. Thank you. okay there.
Real good, girl. Real good.
Go.
Okay, come on, get you back to the doctor.
Whoa!
did not count on seeing that wagon again. Nor you, for that matter.
The only people you won't be seeing are the folks that took it.
I take it they aren't the only ignorant bullying clodhoppers in these parts. But I can live in glorious hope. Now, it wasn't a trouble now, was it?
No, it was a pleasure.
Well, let me give you something for your pleasure. What we got here? How about this? Provide a man a tincture, he'll be well for a day. Teaching to make one, he might be well a while longer.
I'll make sure to try and make this. Thank you.
Thank you. It won't work for anything chronic, but you may not need it to. Well, if you see me on my travels and you're in need of something, make sure you come and say hello.
Travel safe now. Hey there, partner. Hey, partner.
Listen, have you seen... I'm looking for my friend, Gavin.
I don't know any Gavins, I'm afraid.
English bloke. Lovely fella. He went missing, and now I'm all alone.
Good luck.
That's too bad.
Hey, friend.
I am so worried.
Gav! 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 Where are you? Where are you?
You good, girl?
It is. I'm still picking the dust out from my teeth. So what do you say we go again? First one of Catfish Jackson's.
How could I say no?
Ready? Let's go.
Thank you.
want to look into getting a new horse, partner.
Well, damn. You won that fair and square.
And it won't be the last time. Mark my words. Be safe out there.
On that fair and square. Easy there, girl. Yeah. You done good, girl.
You.
Well, looks like you boys had some trouble.
Yeah, we had some trouble. Bad trouble. What you want?
Oh, I was supposed to meet some business partners here. They arranged a meeting, I believe.
Fellow with a scar and a Mexican?
Yes, sir.
Out by the stables, I think.
Thank you. And, sorry for your troubles, friend. There's a girl. You done good, girl.
And there's trouble everywhere. Bandits attack my fields. Men getting killed. Just who are you?
And have you met my partner, Arthur Morgan?
No.
I met your son, the sheriff.
Okay.
Mr. Gray here was saying how he had problems with a family. A family of degenerates.
Oh, well, nobody likes degenerates.
Hag and her inbred sons. They ruined this county. They killed my uncle, you know.
That ain't right.
Problem is, we can't be seen to get too close.
And?
We've got gold, Yankee. We've got gold.
I ain't no Yankee, friend. I ain't nothing. My daddy came over on the boat from Scotland.
I'm Scottish.
And the Braithwaites?
Goddamn peasants. I don't know. Mongrels. Slave fuckers. All you gotta do is look at them.
How much gold?
Enough. These are prized horses I'm talking about. Them, they'll get you 5,000.
5,000? For horses?
Easy.
Where do we sell them, these $5,000 horses?
Over in Clemens Cove. Fell over there will run them out of state and give you 50 cents on the dollar.
Mister, you got yourself a deal.
Just keep us away from this. Publicly, I mean.
My sense is we keep all horse wrestling away from the public.
Go to the stables on the south side of the manor. That's where they keep the thoroughbreds.
I just wanted to say, it's a pleasure working for your family, Mr. Gray.
Hey, boy.
Torched his tobacco crop.
That was you?
The old man was cursing the Braithwaites about that.
Burning rich folks' property? Sean was like a pig in shit.
I'm sure. 5,000 for horses. They must be rich.
Yeah, he doesn't know what he's talking about. But if we get even a third of that, it'll be worth it.
So how are we gonna play this?
The place is well guarded, so there ain't no point in blasting in there. We'll make them think we're there looking to purchase.
Three armed men?
You'd be armed if you were about to spend 5,000 on horses. We should go in the back way, though. Avoid too many questions.
Speak to him, okay?
All right, then.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yeah, we're here to see about some horses.
Horses?
Yeah, we had an appointment with Mr. Braithwaite, I believe.
Yeah, I never heard about any of this.
Our partner wanted to make a significant investment in some stables down here. But perhaps we should look elsewhere.
Well, okay, then. But head on up to the stables. Someone comes here.
Whoa. Easy.
Yeah.
That's it. Nice and easy. No need to rush. We don't want to draw any unnecessary attention. All right. I think that's the stables just up ahead. Heads down. Play cool. Head around the front. Hitch up there.
Hallelujah.
All right, let's hitch up here.
Easy. You can rest now, bro.
Let me do the talking. Hello there.
Can I help you, boys?
I hope so. Heard you got some horses.
We always got horses.
Fine horses, I mean.
I don't get you, friend.
Yeah, you do. Come on.
Listen, why don't you get out of here? You, Scarface, and your greaser buddy.
Whoa!
I don't like officials.
We ain't officials. We're connoisseurs, looking to do some breedings. Come on now, partner.
Okay, fine. Follow me. These here's mainly the studs available for purchase or for working. If that's what you're interested in. What is your boys interested in?
We represent a famous stable and stud farm from Saratoga.
Is that so?
Unofficially.
Of course. This here's Cerberus. Here you go, boy. Cerberus is a real reliable stud.
Uh-huh, greaser, huh?
Okay. Bandana's on. Don't need nobody recognizing us.
All right, I'll grab the white one in the middle. You get the other two. Relax, boy. Come on.
Good boy.
Whoa there. Easy.
Easy
now.
Whoa,
no, easy. Marston.
Get easy there.
Marston, you're going to tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay.
Javier, you're going to lead the stallions. Easy, boy. Good boy.
This way. Come on.
Marston, you ride point. I'll cover up the back if there's any problems.
What are you doing?
Let's go, quick!
Get going, you two. I'll watch the
What the hell are you doing? Stop! Stop! You're being robbed! I said stop these men! Stop!
You son of a bitch!
Ah!
Horses to Clemens Cove.
Whoa, you okay there, boy?
Shit! One of the stallions is loose. Keep going. I'll get him. Come here. Hey, hey.
Over here!
You got him! Well done. Clemens Cove is just over there. Come on. Let's get this over with.
Well, that could have gone smoother.
That'll be on my gravestone. You think they look like they're paying $5,000 for horses?
I guess we'll see.
What you boys want?
Heard you pay good prices for horses.
Oh, we'll buy more or less anything, Pop.
That so?
Sure, Pop. I'm Clay Davies. That's my brother Clive. We're twins.
John, Arthur, Javier.
So what are you? Cuban?
No.
I don't like Cubans.
That so?
Maybe. Why, what do you care? You ain't Cuban.
Maybe I like Cubans.
Ooh, you're funny. He's funny. Ain't he funny, Clive? Clive don't talk. We're twins, but I was born first. He came out all yellow and black, but he's okay.
Sure.
Yeah, I know these horses. They ain't yours. But I like you, and I can give you $650 for
them. I was told we could get up to $5,000 for them.
And I was told the moon was made of ladies' tears. Only it ain't true. Not one little bit.
But...
I like you boys. But I ain't got more than $700 on me. You want it, or you want to ride them fellers into town, and maybe someone there will hang you.
We're gonna need more than that.
I ain't got no more money, Pop. Here, take it or leave it. Uh-huh.
All right.
You goddamn fool, Marston.
Ain't no one around here got $5,000, boys, but nice meeting you. See you boys again, I hope. Come on. Yeah. Close the gate, Clive.
Believed a yarn spun us by one of that Gray family and imagined we was gonna be wonderfully rich. At the end of it, we felt like prize idiots.